Inning 4, designated hitter, number 6, Nick Wilson.
Good afternoon, and we're here live at Jimmy John's Field. 85 degrees outside, the sun's out, tons of fan here. It's country music night. I'm Dave Soseski alongside James Zarnick. James, as we've said a lot during this season, another perfect day for baseball.
Yeah, we've had a lot of them here at Jimmy John's Field. Lots of perfect days for baseball, and this one's just right there with it. Like you said, 85 degrees. The sun's out, country music night, and fireworks to end the game as the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers take on the East Side Diamond Hoppers in tonight's matchup.
James, last night the Diamond Hoppers coming off a 5-1 victory yesterday, a game in which they got their fourth win of the year. Both teams today are coming in at 4-3. Obviously, the Beavers, four wins in a row. For both of these teams, the key has been great pitching alongside with the hitting. Yesterday, the pitching of the Diamond Hoppers only giving up two hits, and a great day by them all around, offensively putting up 5 runs, just putting it all together as a team, playing collectively good baseball. Another good day for Cam Stewart, 3 hits. Tom Nagy putting up a home run.
First of the year. Massive shot to straightaway center field.
Now, James, with the win streak with the Beavers, let's take a look at that. Obviously, 4 games in a row, very impressive. Two guys that we've talked a lot about this season, Alex Bell and Nick Wilson, 12 RBIs combined this season. I would have to go with, if you're going to go with key to a victory today, I'm going to go with them two. What about you?
Yeah, it's going to be them two along with Alex Kinch, who's the starting pitcher for them tonight. But Alex Bell has been the story of their team ever since he's joined the team. 3 games, 14 at-bats. He's got 9 hits, 3 doubles, a triple, 6 RBIs. As we referred to him in the last broadcast, he's a hitting machine. We're going to get the national anthem underway here. We'll be back with starting lineups and we'll be ready for the first pitch as the Diamond Hoppers take on the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers.
With the singing of our national anthem, tonight being performed by 12-year-old Bella Arini.
Yeah! Can you see by the dawn's early light what so twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
As they say, the great words, play ball. As I said, I'm Dave Soseski alongside James Zarnick. James is going to give you the lineups today for the Beavers.
All right, leading off and playing center field for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers, Dave Pepe. In the two hole, playing his second game with the Beavers, Aaron Bossy, second baseman. Batting third, left fielder Eric Phillis. In the cleanup spot, the DH tonight, Nick Wilson. Alex Bell getting the catching duty behind the plate and batting fifth. Number in the six hole, Dan Kinnon, third base. 7, Corey Slater playing first base. Batting 8th, right fielder Miles Williams. And rounding up the order in the 9 hole, DJ Martinez, the shortstop.
And for the defense, for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers, Drue Bravo, on the mound making his first start. Chris Power behind the plate. At first base, Jamie McMillan. Second base will be Cam Stewart. Shortstop, Ricky Castro. Alex Delgado at the hot corner at third base. Joey Fiorino in left field. Alex Santana plays center field. And roaming in right field, Tom Nagy. First start of the season, as I mentioned, for Drue Bravo. Somebody who has been relieving and been very effective so far this season.
Yeah, he's been very effective, only giving up 3 hits in his 6 2/3 innings pitched. He has only 1 earned run charge against him, 8 strikeouts. He does have a win under his belt in the league. And the scouting report on Bravo tonight is it is his first start, so really they got to start lengthening him his arm out and going. So he's look for him to go 3 to 4 innings tonight. One thing pitching coach Justin Orenduff mentioned is the big thing with Bravo is he's got to have better vision and repeat that vision. It's because he has the funky, like, Japanese-style windup mixed in with Tim Lincecum, and he takes his eye off of his target, which is the catcher's glove, and that causes him to drift towards first base and kind of throws off his control. So we'll see if he's able to keep that vision in check and stay square to home plate and drive home with the ball.
Okay, and starting this game off is the center fielder, Dave Pepe. First pitch to Dave Pepe is a strike on the outside corner. Good job there by Bravo to start this game. Bravo 6th in the league so far this season with a 1.35, as we said, all his appearances in relief. The 0-1. Pepe hits that to left field. That might get out of play, but oh, a nice, looked like a running play there. Got a little far on that outfielder, and that's Joey Fiorino out there. Couldn't tell with the sun. That might have been a little bit of a botherance for him there, but nonetheless covered a lot of ground there, as we've mentioned this season. The outfield, lots of room in that foul territory.
Yeah, it looked like he was approaching the weather tarp, and kind of took his eye off the ball maybe a quick second, and it hit him in the heel of the glove and wasn't able to corral it.
The 0-2 pitch. Pepe takes that for a ball outside. 1-2 on the count on Dave Pepe, this speedy center fielder. The 1-2. Pepe hits that out of play, hits the screen here at the backstop. Another beautiful day, as I mentioned. 84 degrees, first pitch. Country music night. James, you a country music fan?
I am a country music fan. I enjoy listening to some country music out at the pool or in some warm weather.
And Pepe slaps that out to left field. James, that's all you can ask for out of your leadoff guy. Pepe starting off the way that you're supposed to, getting on here. Let's see if he can be a botherance on the bases using that speed.
Yeah, he saw 5 pitches in that bat, fouled some off, got the extra life when Fiorino dropped that fly ball in foul territory, and then he slapped the ball over the shortstop's head for a single.
Aaron Bossy up at the plate. Takes the first pitch for a strike. Now, James, you mentioned some things about Aaron Bossy his last game. Quite a hitter at Marshall.
Yeah, he led Marshall. He had 75 hits in his senior season.
Bossy hits that to the shortstop. Castro goes to 2. And a nice breakup there by Dave Pepe. Good slide there to stop that double play from happening.
Yeah, it didn't look like Castro got the ball out of his glove extremely, like, fluently. He bobbled it a little bit there and caused the throw to be a little late, allowing Pepe the time to slide and break up that double play. So we still have a runner on first base, Aaron Bossy.
Yeah, that was just a good baseball play there by Dave Pepe. As you said, Castro probably didn't get that ball out in time, kind of got stuck there in his glove, but good job by Pepe to break that up. runner on, one out, and Eric Phillis up to bat. And a throw over by Bravo, keeping Bossy close.
Phillis is the left-handed batter. He's got five hits on this season, average around 217. He's also got five walks and five RBIs.
The first pitch to Phillis is hit out of play on the left side. Phillis also comes in here tied with Cam Stewart, the second baseman for the Diamond Hoppers, with five RBIs. That is second behind, as we've mentioned, Nick Wilson, who leads with six. The 0-1 pitch is a ball, 1-1. Bossy gets a lead at first. Bravo steps off, looking for his pitch. Asks for this, to see the signs again. The 1-1 pitch from Bravo is low in the dirt there for a 2-1 count. We have one out, top of the first. One hit so far for the Beavers. The 2-1. Bravo steps off again. Looks like he's having a little bit of issues getting the sign there from his catcher. Here's the 2-1, and that's going to be outside, 3-1. You got to think, with that pitch count, it's going to be very important for him to be efficient in these innings. As you said, probably going to only go two or three. The 3-1, and that ball is late there at second base, seeing some good speed there by Bossy as he gets his first stolen base of the season. So not only can he hit, as you mentioned, from Marshall, but he's also got his first stolen base here in the USPBL.
It also looked like Drue Bravo was helped out a little bit there. Ball kind of tailing away from left-handed Phillis. Must have just caught the outside corner of the plate for strike two.
The full count pitch here. And that's hit out to left field over the third baseman's head. Bossy's going to round third. He's going to score on that play. And that is another RBI there for Phillis. Great piece of hitting there into left field, James.
Hey, he noticed Bravo was trying to pitch him outside. He didn't try to do too much with the outside pitch there and the full count. He just went the opposite way with the ball and got himself an RBI as Bossy scored without a throw from left field.
That'll be his sixth RBI of the season to tie his teammate Nick Wilson.
As well as Alex Bell.
And here is Nick Wilson, the big power-hitting first baseman. First pitch to him, and that ball's hit out to center field. That is a no-doubter. That ball is out of here. Wow. That is... It's nice to just kind of stop and just look at that ball. Just keeps traveling off his bat. There's a different sound, James, and we've been able to see that power all season long. That's his fifth home run of the season and his eighth RBI. We're just seeing a remarkable player coming to his own in this USPBL young season.
Yeah, that was a ball hit to dead center field into the wind, and the center fielder took two steps and watched the ball go over the center field fence.
And that will bring up Alex Bell. It doesn't get any easier, as you mentioned, six RBIs on the young season for him in just three games. 3-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. One out here, top of the first. The 1-0 pitch is swung on and missed by Alex Bell.
Some I thought that was kind of funny there is Nick Wilson almost passed Eric Phillis on the base pass. Phillis had to kind of kick it into an extra gear when he was about 15 feet from home plate as Nick Wilson almost caught him.
The 1-1 pitch is hit out of play. 1-2. Yeah, you think Phillis might...
He was
Phillis
trying.
Probably enjoys seeing that just as much as Nick Wilson. He was admiring that shot as the wind really played some tricks out there. Center fielder Santana didn't know if that was going to drop in or not. The 1-2 is a ball to even the count at 2-2.
Yeah, that was more to right center field, kind of where the cutout is, and it goes out to a point. That's probably about 405, 410 feet out to that point of the ball field.
2-2 pitch hit to second baseman Cam Stewart. Nice play there, and he'll throw over to first to get the second out. Showing some nice range there by Cam Stewart.
Yeah, nice backhanded play. Just played the hop and took it nice and smooth. Tossed it over to McMillan for a easy out there.
Another one of those second basemen, as we talked about, with all the second basemen so far we've seen with them going with the high sock look. And that'll bring up Dan Kennan, third baseman for the Beavers. Two outs here, top of the first, 3-0 Beavers on the home run by Nick Wilson. And that'll drop in there for a strike. 0-1 on the count to Dan Kennan. The 0-1 pitch. Kennan hits that just foul down the first baseline to put the count at 0-2. So getting nice production early on from Eric Phillis and Nick Wilson, two of the big guys who've led this offense along with Alex Bell so far in this season.
That's why they hit in the middle of the order. That's why they're your 3-4 hitters. You expect those guys to produce runs, and that's exactly what they've done here in the top half of the first.
The 0-2 is hit out to right field, and Nagy will catch that one to end this inning, but a very productive inning for the Beavers as they lead 3-0 over the Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
Gary with you. We come to you from a jam-packed Chevy Pavilion. Awesome night here on Country Music Night. Let's welcome our in-house band tonight, the great Cadillac West. Give it up.
And we're back here at Jimmy John's Field. 3-0 Beavers lead over the Hoppers. As the Beavers take the field, James Zarnik has got your Diamond Hoppers lineup.
Leading off and playing shortstop, Ricky Castro. In the two-hole, second baseman Cam Stewart. DH work tonight goes to Corey Caswell. In the fourth spot, Alex Delgado, the third baseman. Batting fifth, Jamie McMillan, the first baseman. Sixth, center fielder Alex Santana. Seventh, Tom Nagy, the right fielder. Betting eighth, Chris Power playing catcher tonight. And betting ninth is Joey Fiorino playing left field.
Your outfield from left to right, Eric Phillis in left field, Dave Pepe in center field, right field Miles Williams with a strong arm out there. On the mound, Alex Kinch. Behind the plate, Alex Bell. Playing first base, Corey Slater. At second, Aaron Bossy. At shortstop, DJ Martinez, and at third base, Dan Kennan. Alex Kinch on the mound, as we mentioned. What do you got on Alex Kinch, James?
Well, as we've said, big-time strike thrower, this guy. He's going to work from 84 to 87 miles per hour. He mixes his off-speed pitches very well, and he throws those in any type of count. He's got a lot of movement on his pitches, and he's working on letting the ball travel further and increase his velocity. Looking to go longer in games, they're trying to stretch this guy out, and he's got to work on consistently finishing his delivery.
First pitch there to Ricky Castro is a ball. Yeah, Kinch comes into this game with a .96 ERA, so it's been very effective early on in the season. The 1-0 pitch, Castro hits foul. Looked like that went just off to the side there. Alex Kinch run into that ball, but that goes foul for a 1-1 count. 3-0, Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers over the east side Diamond Hoppers. The 1-1 pitch. Castro hits that over to first baseman Slater, and he takes that himself for the first out. Good job there by Kinch to get that out.
Second baseman, number two, Cam Stewart.
Easy ground ball there from the first hitter, Ricky Castro. Ground ball to the first baseman, and takes it himself for the easy put out.
That'll bring up second baseman Cam Stewart. The first pitch to Stewart is a fastball high, 1-0 on the count.
Cam's had a good year. He's got 8 hits on the year, 5 RBIs. He does have the home run, scoring a lot of runs as well. 5 runs and reached base 5 times via the walk.
The 1-0 is taken there for a strike to even the count at 1-1. Kinch sets and delivers. The 1-1 hit over to shortstop DJ Martinez, and he'll throw that over to Slater for an easy second out. Another ground ball, another easy out.
Hey, when you hit your location with your pitches like Kinch does a lot, you get the hitters to do what you want with it. He's got good lay movement on his fastball, and they're just pounding it into the ground right now.
That'll bring up Corey Caswell.
Caswell played college ball at Ithaca. He's one of the league leaders in hitting up there with Alex Bell, batting 421 on the season.
The 0-1 to Caswell is taken for a strike. Nice off-speed pitch there by Kinch for an 0-2 count, 2 outs. Bottom of the first inning, 3-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. The 0-2 swung on and missed. Good pitch there by Alex Kinch to retire the side in order. We'll go to the second inning. Beavers leading 3-0 over the Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to introduce to you Jimmy Johns Field, Ultimate DJ, the notorious PUG. Let's see your moves on the dance cam. Folks, get off of your seats and dance to the beat. Get up and move.
And we're back here for the top of the second inning. Drue Bravo back on the mound. A very efficient inning there by Alex Kinch. Drue Bravo trying to do the same. As we already mentioned, James, he is on a pitch count today. Had a little bit of a rough inning that first inning there, giving up a home run by Nick Wilson and an RBI single by Phillis.
Look to be for him to be more efficient here in the second inning. Like we said, Bravo's pitched a lot out of relief for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers, appearing 4 games before tonight's start. So he's had plenty of work. He's used to coming out of the bullpen. First start for him tonight, though.
The 0-1 pitch to Corey Slater is hit on the right side. McMillan giving chase, but that ball's going to just get over the rail there in the Beavers' dugout to put the count at 0-2. That would have been a really hard play there from McMillan, who was giving chase, dealing with the sun, as well as trying to find that railing.
Yeah, good effort there. And like you said, these players are still getting used to this ballpark, although they have played 7 games, each of them this being their 8th. You still got to still play some time to get used to how things go and what kind of room you have over there in foul territory. Even though it's so much with the dugouts being in a different position, it can kind of throw things off than what you're used to.
Ball there to Slater. The 1-2 pitch from Bravo is in the dirt to even the count at 2-2. Sunny in 84 today. Beautiful weather here on Country Music Night, as well as fireworks after the game. the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss by Slater. Good pitch there by Drue Bravo for the first out of the inning.
Nice curveball low and away. Got Corey Slater to swing right over the top of that pitch. And like we said, there's a good start right there for Drue Bravo to be more efficient in this inning. Gets the leadoff man out.
Miles Williams up to the plate here. The first pitch to the right fielder is swung on and missed. Now, Miles almost had a home run last game. We do believe his swing is getting close, James.
Yeah, and manager Chris Newell countered and said the same exact thing. He thinks Miles is really close, puts in a lot of hard work.
Miles hits that out to center field. That looks like that's going to get over the center fielder's head. And right center field there, Miles going around second, but he'll stop there, hitting the gap with that one, getting a double on this. I believe that's his first double of the season. We'll have to check that, but nice piece of hitting by a guy whom we said it was only a matter of time before that bat heats up.
Yeah, and just like I was saying before the hit there, Chris Newell said he's a guy that works real hard. He's here early taking extra swings for BP. He knows he's a good hitter. He was just that second or that slight little bit off, and double here in the second inning. Maybe Miles has found that swing.
That'll bring up DJ Martinez. First pitch to Martinez is a ball. 1-0. Miles Williams at second base, one out. The 1-0. Martinez hits that in the right field. Good play there by Nagy, battling the sun. Miles is tagging on that play. Very aggressive base running by Miles Williams as he saw that Nagy struggle with that sun a little bit out there.
He really decided to tag late. I mean, when Nagy caught that ball out in right field, Miles was still heading back to the bag to tag up. It's not like he was waiting on second to take off and go. So kind of made a late decision to tag there, but the right one, because, I mean, it takes a couple good throws to get you out there in right field, furthest position away from third base. So Miles moves up on the fly ball to right field.
That'll bring up Dave Pepe for his second at-bat. Pepe singled his first at-bat. That is a 0-1 count on Pepe. Yeah, we'll look for more of that this game. It looks like it could be an issue out there in the outfield with the sun. Second pitch to Pepe, and he slaps that into left field over the third baseman's head. And that'll put another run on the board. 4-0 Beavers. Good job there by Pepe, who's 2-for-2 in this baseball game.
Yeah, Pepe looks real comfortable in the play there up to bat. The same, hit the ball in almost the same exact play. Slapped it out to left field as the left-handed hitter and plates another run here for the Beavers in the top half of the second inning.
A Beavers team who their last game won 7-0. First pitch there to Bossy is a ball outside, but they just keep on hitting. 5 hits already, and we're not even out of the second inning here. And the 1-0 pitch to Bossy as Bravo steps off the mound.
Bravo and Powers trying to get on the same page here.
Ooh, that one a little in. Well, that really inside there at the letters, but Bossy moves out of the way of that one. 2-0 on Aaron Bossy, who's 0-for-1 on the day. 3-0. Got to think that pitch count already becoming a problem for Bravo. Look for somebody to start working out there in that bullpen. The 3-0. Taken all the way there by Aaron Bossy.
Surprised he didn't have the green light there. Guy's playing in his second game. It is already 4-0. You got two outs here.
3-1, excuse me, is taken foul back. Looks like Dave Pepe was going a hit and run on there. Really aggressive so far in this game for the Beavers, who, as we said, 4 wins in a row. They just look like a team that's hitting on all cylinders once again here early on. And the full count pitch That's hit up the middle. Oh, but snagged there by Drue Bravo. Good play there to end that inning, or else that one might get up center field there for another single. But nevertheless, we are going to the bottom of the second inning. 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
Tom, where are you from?
I'm here in McComb.
Here's what we're going to do. Brush up on our baseball, the trivia question. The following question, Tom, you have to answer. We're going to throw the answers up on the scoreboard, and you've got to pick one. What happens when the ball gets stuck in the umpire's or catcher's mask? A, all runners advance one base. B, a ball is called. C, a batter is awarded first base. What do you think?
I think it's C.
C, batter is awarded first base. No, it is A. All runners advance one base. Now, bear in mind you got it wrong. That was a doozy, right? Get it, Dr. Christopher?
And we're back here at Jimmy John's Field as Alex Kinch takes the mound for the bottom of the second inning. Good job by Alex Kinch in that first inning, James, getting some easy ground outs to get out of there unscathed and a low pitch count for him.
Did you know that trivia question that came up on the board?
What one was that?
It was, what happens when the ball gets lodged or stuck in the umpire or a catcher's mask?
What was the answer?
It was that the runners on base are awarded a free base.
I don't think I've ever seen that. First pitch here to Alex Delgado, third baseman for the Diamond Hoppers. I don't think I've seen that before.
No, I can't remember a time where I've seen a ball get lodged or stuck in a catcher or umpire's mask.
0-1 pitch is waved at and missed by Alex Delgado. If it's going to happen to anybody, you have to think it would have been Alex Avila, who just seemed to always get hit with some kind of foul tip. And that's hit foul down the third baseline softly to keep the count at 0-2.
Delgado's been one of the more steady hitters for the Diamond Hoppers this season, batting .348. He has 8 hits, only 2 RBIs, but scored 5 runs and walked 5 times.
Waved on and missed there by Delgado, who, as you said, came in here hitting .348 on the season, but good job of that off-speed pitch location there from Alex Kinch.
Yeah, down and away, but they had a lot of movement on it, and it really kind of threw Delgado off, and he had 2 of them in that at-bat that he swung and missed at, just kind of waved at, didn't really have a good swing.
Jamie McMillan steps up to the plate and takes a strike.
How about this? Aaron Bossy is about 5 steps into right field at the second base position, as McMillan, the left-handed batter's up.
Now, you asked me a question about a week ago about sabermetrics and if they're going to do, after this pitch. 1-1 pitch is hit down to third base. Good job there by Kennan with a strong throw for the second out. But you had asked me if teams were going to put the shift on certain hitters. And I mean, that's not a shift right there, but you didn't see that before.
No, that's definitely not a shift. I don't know if Bossy did that on his own, something he's more comfortable doing, but
now you got him playing right behind the bag there. Well, a little bit over to first base side behind that bag there, but he's playing
way closer to second base than normal.
Yeah, first pitch was a strike there to Alex Santana. 1-1 the count here on the center fielder for the Diamond Hoppers. The 1-1 is taken for a called strike 2 on the outside corner. Good pitch there by Alex Kinch. The 1-2 is checked at, but gets away from the catcher, and Santana's going to reach on a strikeout on that pass ball from Alex Bell there.
That ball looked like it kind of crossed Alex Bell up, and it hit him. It didn't even hit him in any of his pads. It looked like it hit him up underneath the leg and ricocheted all the way down about halfway to third base, but all the way along the wall there on the dirt that goes around. So
yeah, he had a hard time picking that one up. Bell, as we've seen play last game, a couple innings at catcher, has played DH and third base. Tom Nagy comes to the plate. First pitch to Nagy is a strike on the outside corner.
Nagy had the home run last night. Also shown the ability to draw walks, as he has 7 base on balls this season.
Kinch sets and delivers. Swung on and miss. Off speed pitch there from Kinch. 0-2, keeping Nagy off balance.
Kinch has been all over the strike zone tonight, working his fastball and very strong with his off-speed pitches in there, keeping batters off balance.
The 0-2 is hit down right field line. That's trouble if it's fair, but that's just foul. That looks like that would have been a for sure RBI there for Tom Nagy and possibly 2 bases, but just foul, as Miles Williams was giving chase to that ball. That'll keep the count at 0-2 to Tom Nagy. Kinch sets and delivers. Nagy hits that past the third baseman and shortstop. That'll get into left field. So 1-for-1 on the day already for Tom Nagy, who had a nice ball game yesterday, as we already mentioned, a home run.
Yeah, he had the home run, and that's just a good piece of hitting there. He stays in, pulls his hands inside of that inside pitch, and hits the ball through the diving shortstop and third baseman over there. Both of them giving a good effort on the ball, but Nagy hit it hard through the hole between them, so runners on first and second for the Diamond Hoppers here in the second.
That'll bring up Chris Power doing the catching duties today for the Diamond Hoppers, as Kinch steps off and looks the runner back at second base there.
Power's been very good when he's been in the games this year. He's a couple hits, a couple RBIs even. Let's see if he can get a big 2-out hit here.
First pitch is outside. 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. Bottom of the second here, 2 outs. Runners on second and first. And Chris Power hitting 375 so far with a 1-0 count. The pitch is taken for a strike right down the pipe there by Alex Kinch for a 1-1 count. Kinch steps off the mound. Kinch sets the 1-1. Is a ball outside. Looks like the ump wanted to go around on that strike.
It looked like a really good pitch there from Kinch.
Up on the big board, they liked it. They put it as a strike, but it will go down as a ball. 2-1 on the count. The 2-1 to Chris Power. Swung on and fouled over on the right side to even the count at 2-2.
I guess they did call that as...
Well, it depends where you're looking at it, because it says a ball here. And
now it's 2-2, so the one was a ball.
And the 2-2 is low and outside. Yeah, it was kind of questionable there. As you said, the ump wanted to go around there. It was just on the edge. Three-two count. Payoff pitch coming here from Alex Kinch. And the pitch, as Power hits that over to the first baseman, Slater, who makes a good play, throwing it to Kinch running over there. That'll get them out of the inning. We'll go to the top of the third. Beavers still leading this game 4-0 over the Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
Who likes green cupcakes? Right? Make some noise. Exactly. Our friends at Vincent Joe's Gourmet Market, who do Vincent Joe's Lucky 15 each and every night here at Jimmy John's Field. That means a lucky section in two rows go home with three gourmet cupcakes courtesy of Vincent Joe's. The market is the best. Our Detroit winner, the whole thing. All right, our lucky section tonight, I'm here. 105, rows 3 and 4. Yes, kids, you're going home with gourmet cupcakes, and somebody, look under your seat, is going to have a $30 gift card to Vincent Joe's as well. Get some gelato at their stand outside of section 102. Thank you, Vincent Joe's.
And we're back here at Jimmy John's Field for the top of the third inning. Good job so far by Alex Kinch, James, pitching out of a little bit of trouble there to keep the score at 4-0 Beavers,
you know,
who have started off well.
It was kind of some unfortunate trouble as he got the strike three pitch there to Alex Santana, just bounced away from the catcher, Alex Bell. So he ended up with the guy on first base, gave up the hit to Tom Nagy. Out into left field, but able to close the door and get the ground out to first baseman Corey Slater there to end the inning, and still no damage done on the scoreboard.
Yeah, as we mentioned, 4-0 Beavers, who already have 5 hits. Drue Bravo, you have to think this possibly could be his last inning of work, as you mentioned, on a pitch count, pitching out of the bullpen so far this season.
Yeah, they're just looking to work him out and get him. They might work on stretching him a little bit longer here, time at a time, but he's got to get outs and he's got to be effective with it, all his pitches out there on the mound.
That'll bring up Eric Phillis, who in the first inning had a single and a RBI, the first RBI of the day for the Beavers. First pitch to Phillis is a ball. That pitch looked pretty good. Might have been a little low there.
It looked like power kind of scooped it up off the dirt a little bit, or just above.
The 1-0 to Eric Phillis is a strike at 1-1. Bravo sets and delivers. Strike on the outside. Nice pitch there by Drue Bravo.
Phillis didn't like it, but as you said, Bravo painting the outside corner.
The 1-2 pitch. Ball outside to even the count at 2-2.
He tried it there again, just a little bit too far that time. Umpire wasn't budging on that call.
The 2-2 pitch. Phillis pops that ball up. That'll get out to the left fielder. Good job there by Fiorino, battling the sun a little bit there to get the first out of the inning.
It's a good pitch there by Bravo to get Eric Phillis underneath that and pop it up to the left fielder.
And here's the man of the hour so far. Definitely the story of this game. Nick Wilson, as we said last inning, had a 2-run bomb out to right center field.
Nick was drafted in the 24th round by the Tampa Bay Rays from Georgia. He went to a school in Atlanta.
The 0-1 pitch is a ball to even the count at 1-1. Yeah, he played a season with their minor league affiliate with 11 home runs, so he did display that pop. The 1-1 is a ball. And, you know, something that we've seen so far and mentioned is he can work a count as well. He's a very patient hitter up there.
He's not going to go chasing pitches. You're going to have to throw him strikes to get him out, and that's never a safe thing to do. Do stuff like that there, keep him off balance as he was kind of out in front of that pitch from Bravo.
That's a good job there by Bravo. Count at 2-2 to Big Nick Wilson, who's 1-for-1 with a home run. The 2-2. That's a ball outside to put the count at 3-2. The 3-2 pitch is swung on and hit foul softly behind the catcher there to keep the count at 3-2.
People keep on pouring in to watch this game here as the Diamond Hoppers take on the Beavers.
Nick Wilson hits that down to third baseman Delgado, who makes a strong throw for the second out of the inning. It's become pretty automatic down there for Alex Delgado at third base with that arm.
Yeah, he's a very good fielder down at third base.
A guy that can hit as well, as we've mentioned numerous times this season.
That was a very good pitch there by Drue Bravo. He got Nick Wilson way off balance out in front of the ball and weakly hit a ground ball to third base.
As Alex Bell steps in and takes the first pitch for a ball, 1-0 on Alex Bell. Bravo stops the delivery and delivers. That's hit out to right field, but that's going to go foul there into the Beavers' bullpen. Wasn't sure where that one dropped at first. Looks like right field is where that sun is going to be battled there, but looks like it's everybody who's up on that hill battling it rather than the right fielder as the sun sets here on a beautiful night of baseball. The 1-1. Bell hits that out of play on the right side here to put the count at 1-2. Two outs. Top of the third. 4-0. Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. The 1-2 is taken for a ball high to even the count at 2-2 to Alex Bell. The hitting machine, as we've referred to early on so far this year, the 2-2. Bell hits that taps that behind the screen. Just a little late there on that changeup.
Good at bat here by Bell. He's really battling, seeing a lot of pitches from Bravo, and just following the ones he doesn't like off out of back to the screen or out of play, and waiting to get his pitch.
The 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Good pitch there by Drue Bravo. And that'll end the top of the third inning. We'll go to the bottom of the third. The score still 4-0 Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers over the East Side Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
I'm not doing that today. Who wants a t-shirt? We got t-shirts coming from the concourse. Turn around. We got t-shirts in all sections. Oh, man. How are you doing that? Awesome. Can you get a t-shirt? You got to catch one. They're coming, folks. We're at School 59. They're throwing t-shirts. We got the mascots in the house tonight. Oh, here's Tyler, our intern. Oh, there's one to Scott. You can meet Lancelot coming down in section 103. We got the mascots. We got t-shirts. We're all over the park tonight. Hope you're having a great time here at Jimmy John's Field. Coming from all angles tonight for t-shirts. Take them home. Of course, you can purchase t-shirts at all of our merchandise stands, including the great shop down the right field line, folks. Thanks for coming out here on a beautiful Friday night. What's up, Lance? Here's Jimmy John's Field.
And we're back here at Jimmy John's Field for the bottom of the third inning as the Beavers are back on the field. Alex Kinch on the mound. Good job there on that last half inning by Drue Bravo. Somebody, as you said, trying to stretch him out a bit, coming from a relief role of getting out of that inning, giving up no runs after struggling for the first two innings.
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, they got to him. He's thrown 38 strikes, 19 balls in his appearance here. So they might get him one more inning out of him. There's not a lot of work. There's no work going down in the Diamond Hoppers bullpen. So I think we're going to see Drue Bravo for another inning as they work on stretching him out. it helps that he had a very efficient inning, getting the Beavers in order in the top half of the third.
That's a hard transition anyways, because when you're in the bullpen, you can just air it out, come out here and start. You have to, as if we get the first pitch here to Joey Firino for a ball, but you have to learn how to use your pitches, and you can't stress yourself out too much by going too much with your velocity. You have to find a happy medium with that velocity. And when you're coming out of that bullpen, you can just kind of air it out, go with different pitches. But he did a good job so far that half inning. We'll see if he comes out here again. The 1-2 pitch to Joey Fiorino is swung on. Ball pops in front of Alex Bell, and he makes a throw that pulls Corey Slater off the base. And Fiorino will be safe on that play.
So is that going to go down as a strikeout E2?
I would think so. We'll have to see how that one scored. And that's exactly how that's going to go down. And that ball's hit to shortstop for a 6-4-3 double play. That was a wild play as DJ Martinez fell down to his knees there on that ground ball, but was still able to make a fine play.
I think they only got one out there. They didn't get Ricky Castro runs pretty well, and I think him falling a little bit there kind of slowed up the turn process between Martinez and Boston.
Definitely so. Disrupted that play, but still a fine play there by Martinez to recover and get that first out there at second base. But as you said, good speed there by Ricky Castro. First pitch here to Cameron Stewart will not be delivered as Kinch looks over to first base to look Castro back. Cameron Stewart takes the first pitch of this at bat for a strike on the outside corner for a 0-1 count. One out here. Bottom of the third, 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. Cameron Stewart, second baseman for the Diamond Hoppers up there. The 0-1 pitch is a ball outside, 1-1.
Well, with the different color stirrups today, he's been wearing the orange ones the last couple games, black ones today.
The 1-1 pitch to Cam Stewart. As Kinch looks Castro back over there at first base, as you mentioned, a lot of speed by Castro as he beat that out to break up that, or to beat out that double play. 1-1 pitch, Castro goes, and a ball that takes two hops there into second base is recovered by the shortstop there, Martinez. Not a very strong throw there by Alex Bell, who we also saw had a hard time throwing the strikeout over for an out at first base, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. And Diamond Hoppers might be running today as to test the arm of Alex Bell. 2-1 pitch to Cameron Stewart here is a swinging strike. 2-2, good job.
Yeah, that ball from Bell just kind of tailed on him back away from the second baseman, Bossy, covering second base, so kind of pulled him off the bag. The throw was there in time, just bounced and, like I said, tailed away from Bossy.
Yeah, as the shortstop Martinez had to get that ball as it got away from the second baseman there, but able to get to it before it got into center field. The 2-2 pitch is swung on and missed. A little trouble there by Bell. We'll see if he can make a strong throw, and he does. So good recovery there to get the second out of the inning. Ricky Castro still on second base here as Corey Caswell steps in. Corey Caswell, a guy who can catch as well as designate hit as he's DHing today. Chris Power, Corey Caswell, you can't go wrong so far this season.
They've been a good tandem. Caswell getting majority of the time behind the plate, but caught last night, so they'll give him the little break tonight as he DHs. A couple hits last night. He had a double off the wall in left field.
First pitch here by Kinch is a ball. The 1-0. As Caswell hits that to left field, and that'll be the third out. Good catch there by Eric Phillis. To end the inning.
Hit that one off the end of the bat. Didn't barrel it up there.
We will go to the top of the fourth inning. Still at 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel. And we're back at Jimmy John's Field for the top of the fourth inning as the Diamond Hoppers take the field and Drue Bravo back on the mound. So at least one more inning.
Do you know some of the fun facts that happened on today's date in history?
I was looking up there, but I didn't catch it. What happened on this day in history, James?
1855, the Statue of Liberty arrived in New York City. And also in 1994, the O.J. Simpson chase through L.A. and the White Bronco took
place. The White Bronco.
On this date in 1994.
Yeah, usually if you're not guilty, you don't run. But nevertheless, what they say, if the glove doesn't fit, you must acquit. The famous lines of Johnny Cochran there. I don't know if you've had a chance to watch the 30 for 30 on ESPN of the O.J. Simpson case. But
is that the series, the four-phase series that they're doing? I haven't caught it.
Very, very interesting. Definitely worth watching. Good TV there.
He's done a lot of stuff on the O.J. Simpson case.
You wonder if he's getting any of this money.
Well, he's in jail for, selling merchant or stealing
trophies. The first pitch here to Dan Kennan. Kennan pops that out to left field, but that's going to be out number one there as Joey Fiorino battles the sun there for the first out. That'll bring up Corey Slater.
Slater struck out in his first at-bat of the game.
Comes into plate with Wagon Wheel by Darius Rucker, former Hootie and the Blowfish lead singer. First pitch there to Corey Slater is a swinging strike.
All country music tonight, as it is country music night here at Jimmy John's Field.
The 0-1 is swung on and missed there. Good job by Drue Bravo, who coming off a scoreless third inning. Doing a good job to battle back here. One out. 0-2 count to Corey Slater. The pitch. Just missed there on the outside corner as the catcher Power held it a few extra seconds there to try to get that call, but just a ball. The 1-2. Swung on and missed for another strikeout for Drue Bravo. Good job of changing it up there to Corey Slater from Drue Bravo.
Yeah, that last time he got him with a curveball low and away in the zone that Slater swung over top. This time he elevated the fastball, and those high elevated fastballs really are no match for anybody. They always look good as a hitter, but they're hard to catch up to, and most of the time you don't.
First pitch to Miles Williams is swung on and missed there. Miles doing what he does best, be aggressive at that plate as he swings on in that first pitch.
That was a good pitch by Bravo there to start him off with a curveball, expecting fastball, but swings right over the top of the fastball.
The 0-1 pitch is in the dirt there to even the count at 1-1. Yeah, if you know a guy is going to be aggressive, obviously Miles Williams has been that way all season. You're not going to go with that first pitch fastball. You go off speed and try to catch him off balance. The 1-1 pitch is hit up the middle, but good play there by Drue Bravo. And that's going to be the third out. That would have been a single up the middle, but that'll end the inning. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth inning. 4-0 Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers over the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
Without the Dunkin' Donut race, that's right, the classic race between the donut, the bagel, and the coffee, brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts. You see the participants for Section 101, it's Dashing Donut. Representing Section 103, Biggie Bagel, and finally, Section 105, loud cheer for Puppy Coffee. Are you ready? Where are our racers? Oh, they're in the hallway. Come on, guys, get out here. Oh, here they come. Oh, we got ourselves a race. Puppy Coffee in the early lead. Here comes the donut. The donut looks like it's pulling away. The donut gets the win tonight. Well, if you're in Section 101, you're the winner. You'll all be getting a Dunkin' Donut coupon from Crew 59. The donut is tonight's winner, everybody.
Hey fans, tomorrow, if you are one of the first 1,000 fans in the park, you can take home your very own unicorn drawstring.
And we're back for the bottom of the fourth inning here at Jimmy John's Field. I'm Dave Soseski alongside James Zarnick, Alex Kinch back on the hill. James, Alex Kinch has been very effective so far, just the one hit.
Just the one hit, and it came after the strikeout. With the third strike was dropped there in the at-bat to Alex Santana. So Kinch has been very effective, Mitch, using all his pitches off speed. He's really going after these hitters and pounding the strike zone.
First pitch there is a strike to Alex Delgado. Yeah, five strikeouts on those nine outs so far. So a very good start here for Alex Kinch. The 0-1 is hit, tapped foul there behind the catcher, Alex Bell, to put the count at 0-2.
He's really has Delgado off balance with the off-speed pitches, way out in front lunging at the ball.
The 0-2 is a called strike three as they throw it around the horn for another strikeout. That's the sixth strikeout already here in the fourth inning from Alex Kinch, who continues to impress on Country Music Night as big first baseman Jamie McMillan steps up to the plate.
Only 45 pitches for Kinch as he's working into the fourth inning here.
McMillan tries to drop a bunt down there, the third base line, as Dan Cannon was way back there, but that bunt goes foul. You like that bunt idea there by McMillan, James?
I do like the idea, because look at where Kenan's playing. He's going to go right back there again.
Would you dare to do it two times?
He's shaded over towards the shortstop position, and he's 15 steps behind the bag at third base. So if he bunts a ball down to third base and gets it past the pitcher, it's going to be a base hit.
And McMillan doesn't show and takes another strike to put the count at 0-2. The 0-2 count is tapped foul behind the catcher there. 0-2. One out. Bottom of the fourth inning here. 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. Behind Alex Kinch, who has six strikeouts in 3 1/3 innings. That ball will bounce in there to Alex Bell. As we mentioned, beautiful night, Country Music Night, fireworks after the game. You got the grill going, hot dogs, the smell of popcorn, tons of fans here. Baseball on a Friday night, it doesn't get any better, as McMillan swings and fouls that off the umpire to keep the count at 1-2.
It looks like he got the umpire on the bare hand there, on the left hand, but just foul ball at home plate, and Kinch ready to go on the mound.
Yeah, those umpires are tough too. It's not just the catchers. The 1-2 count to Jamie McMillan, and Kinch steps off. to get a new set of signs. And he delivers the 1-2. McMillan swings and misses. What a pitch there. Going off speed and totally fooling Jamie McMillan there.
Yeah, he's got that off speed working, and it really looks like he's following what Nick Jensen Clagg did the other night against the Unicorns. Really had the Unicorns off balance with the off speed pitching. And Alex Kinch is doing the exact same thing here against the Diamond Hoppers. They just can't seem to figure out the off speed pitch.
Alex Santana up to bat here. Takes the first pitch for a strike. That's a good point. That is, it's almost the same performance we're seeing so far. Off-speed variety, and hitters just don't know when it's coming, and they haven't been able to make much contact with it.
Yeah, both the guys work very fast, ready to go as soon as they get the ball back, and they both pound the strike zone and then have this off-speed pitch that they can throw in any count.
There's another ball there taken by Alex Santana. 2-1, the 2-1. Santana hits out down the first base line. That's going to be fair as that hits off the base. And he'll be safe. You don't see that happen too often. Not much he could have done there for Corey Slater.
No, Slater was in position behind the base to make the play, and it takes the unfortunate hop of hitting the front part of the bag and just bounce straight up into the left.
Yeah, that's
to Slater's right, and he tried to grab it with his bare hand, but
that's put down as a hit. I mean, it's not, like we said, there's not much he could have done there.
No.
So nevertheless, that's a hit for the Diamond Hoppers, the second of the day so far, as Tom Nagy takes a very aggressive swing there at the first pitch, but once again, off-speed pitch from Alex Kinch has another hitter off balance to put the count at 0-1 with two outs, runner at first. Is Alex Santana. The 0-1 is a ball outside. 1-1 is the count. As we have a packed house for this one tonight. A lot of country music fans and fireworks fans too as well.
It's just a great place to be on a Friday night. Perfect weather. Come enjoy some really good baseball out here at Jimmy John's Field. I mean, Wednesday through Sunday, you're going to be pleased every time you come out here to the field. You see a good baseball game and just a great atmosphere, family friendly. It's a good time for all families and anybody who wants to see baseball.
The 1-2 pitch is a ball out, ball in the dirt, but good job there by Alex Bell to corral that one. Yeah, like you said, there's something for everybody here too as well. For the kids, there's obviously the mascots who bring a lot of fun to the ballpark. There's the wiffle ball out there. Great food. I mean, you can't go wrong with a nice hot dog on a baseball game with nice weather here. A cold craft beer. There's something for everybody here, and I think these fans have really taken a liking to this ballpark and everything that it offers. Andy Appleby has done a tremendous job putting this all together.
It's a great setup. It's, like you said, a great place to watch baseball. As we got all the fans out in right field sitting on beach towels and blankets.
There's a swing and miss by Nagy. That gets away from Bell, and that is in the dirt again. James, that's the third throw we've seen so far from Bell. Kind of come up a little short. Had trouble with that. You wonder if those first couple throws have kind of gotten his head there and taken away a little bit of that confidence.
Yeah, I mean, he's two strikeout pitches, he's bounced over to the first baseman Slater, and then he had the throw down to second. But that's just, I mean, as a catcher, you kind of rush too much, and it's really a play where you got so much time you don't know what to do with, and you kind of choke the ball and throw it into the ground. But you just got to realize you got more time than you think. Relax and make a good, strong throw like he did on the one to Cam Stewart earlier in the game in the third inning.
First pitch, a strike to Chris Power. Second pitcher outside. That'll be the second error on the day. Charge to Bell. Runners at first and second, two outs here. 4-0, Beavers over the Hoppers. Bottom of the fourth inning here. The powerful Chris Power, no pun intended, up to bat here. count at 1-2. Kinch sets. The 1-2. Power hits that out of play on the right side here. Just the two hits so far for the Diamond Hoppers, but two errors have a runner in scoring position here with two outs, a 1-2 count. Bottom of the fourth inning here, Chris Power. The pitch, a swing on and a miss. Another strikeout there for Alex Kinch, the seventh of the ball game. We will go to the top of the fifth inning here, still at 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
4,000 fans get a Beavers rally call. Gates open at 6 p.m. Get here early for all the fun. And now, fans, if you'd please direct your attention to the video board to watch Landslide, Buzz, and Ribby as they have a blast at the Henry Ford McComb Mid-States Playground Kids Zone. Hey fans, stick around after the game, after the final out. Kids get to run the base.
And we're back here at Jimmy John's Field for the top of the fifth inning. Actually, a correction. I said seven, but that's actually nine strikeouts there for Alex Kinch. James, as you see the rare four strikeout inning off that error.
Yeah, you don't see that very often, but the pass ball to the from the or the pass ball, like you said, on the air, the throw down, and Kinch was able to strike out four. Pitch count still in a very reasonable position as the Diamond Hoppers will bring on the new pitcher, and that will be the 6'5" right-handed pitcher from Lincoln, Rhode Island, John Tangerlini. He's appeared in a couple games for the Diamond Hoppers so far. He's pitched 2 2/3 innings, giving up two hits and two walks while striking out four. Hasn't given up any runs, so good efficient work for Tangerlini so far out of the Diamond Hoppers bullpen.
So that'll be the end of the day for Bravo. Final line on him is 4 innings pitched, 5 hits, 4 runs. But as we said, after the first 2 innings, he settled down and had 2 successful, efficient innings.
He retired 7 in a row to finish the game, or finish his day.
Tangerlini sets on the mound here. First pitch to Martinez is fouled. You know, something interesting here is as you look at 49 strikes from Kinch versus 17 balls, with a ratio like that, you're going to have a ton of success. And we've seen just that so far today.
Yeah, he's, like we've said all along through the broadcast, is he's really pounding the strike zone, just going after the Diamond Hoppers hitters.
Martinez slaps that one as that rolls down the third base. Foul, though, to put the count at 0-2. The 0-2 pitch from Tangerlini is a ball outside. 2-1 from the 6'5", 245 right-hander, the 2-1. Is a ball.
He looks all of 6'5", 245. Big guy out on the mound for the Diamond Hoppers here.
Count actually at 2-2, the 2-2 pitch. Martinez hits that past the shortstop. Hit it where there ain't there, as Delgado could not get to that, either could Castro. Just hitting the perfect spot there between the shortstop and third baseman. Good job of hitting on that soft ground ball there by Martinez.
Yeah, it was a good job there. And That's what you want out of the bottom of your order. Get on base to start off the inning and throw it over to the top part of your lineup and hope to do some more damage here.
As Dave Pepe steps to the plate, a throw over to first base and to McMillan, but Martinez gets back. First pitch to Pepe. Pepe shows bunt, misses on that one for a strike. 0-1 on him. Top of the fifth inning, 4-0 Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers over the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. Beavers with a man at first, no outs, the 0-1. Pepe takes to even the count at 1-1. Good job by Pepe so far, 2-for-2 with two singles, as he's struggled early on this season, but good game so far today.
Doing
that
real
is
good.
A ball.
Doing a good job at the top of the order for the Beavers today, setting the tone early as he led off the game with a single and another hit back in the second inning.
The 2-1 pitch is taken for a strike by Pepe. Tangerlini sets the pitch. The runner goes. That's popped up left side. Delgado runs. Great play by Delgado. As that ball looked to, there's no wind out there, but hard to judge that pitch. And with so much room over there, that can be a hard play. And he did a good job tracking that ball down.
Yeah, good play. When you're a third baseman, those type of plays, you're, the biggest thing to do is to just get to a spot, and then once you get to that spot, you kind of adjust to the ball.
Aaron Bossy hits that down to Delgado. Delgado throws down the second and gets the out. Delgado bobbled that briefly there at third base to make that play a little bit closer than it would have been, but an out nevertheless, but too slow to turn two on that play. As Eric Phillis steps in here, 1-for-2 with a single and an RBI. Phillis takes for a strike on the outside corner. Two outs, one man on, Bossy. 4-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. Top of the fifth inning here at Jimmy Johns Field. The 1-1, that's hit up between the left fielder and right fielder, that's going to hit a gap. Bossy's going to round third here. There will be no throw, and he will score to push that lead to 5-0. Another RBI for Eric Phillis. Great piece of hitting by him to hit the gap there for another RBI double.
Yeah, it was a great hit there. He stayed inside the ball and took the outside pitch and drove it out to the wall and left center field. Santana and Fiorina, who both have really good speed, not able to track it down before it got to the wall. So
something,
Eric Phillis standing on second base.
Something that I've seen from Phillis is he doesn't take wild swings. He's always in control there at the plate. And as you've seen, it's been very effective so far this season. Is he has 7 RBIs on the season as Nick Wilson steps in there. Swinging at that first pitch for a strike. The 0-1 is a ball inside from the 6-5 John Tangerlini to even the count at 1-1 with two outs. Phillis at second. 5-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. The 1-1 pitch is fouled out of play for a 1-2 count to Big Nick Wilson, who we already mentioned had a 2-run homer in the first inning, his 5th of the season. The 1-2 is a ball outside. Good take there by Nick Wilson to even the count at 2-2. The 2-2. Good patience there by Nick Wilson. Good vision, as that was very close on the outside, but that'll put the count at a 3-2 full count. The payoff pitch. Nick Wilson hits that over to Castro. Castro with a short throw, but a good pick there by McMillan at first, and that'll end the inning. One run scores on the Eric Phillis RBI double. 5-0 Beavers over the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth. You're listening to the USPBL YouTube channel.
First base, nice round of applause for Anthony from McCone. Come on, Anthony, he's ready to go. He'll be racing against the Diamond Hoppers mascot, Ribby, and the Beavers mascot, Buzz. Nice round of applause for Buzz and Ribby. All right, Anthony, when I say go, you're going around the bases, my friend. Here we go. Ready, set, go.
And we're back at Jimmy John's Field for the bottom of the fifth inning. So far, this one, all Beavers, 5-0, as we'll throw it over to James Zarnick for the rest of the game. James, this has been a very impressive game so far from the Beavers, off 4 wins in a row. Eric Phillis, 2 RBIs so far.
Yeah, you have Eric Phillis with 2 RBIs. You have the Nick Wilson home run back in the first inning that really set the tone for this game, as they scored 3 runs in the first inning. 7 hits for the Beavers, only 2 for the Diamond Hoppers, and Alex Kinch has been extremely effective and efficient for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. 9 strikeouts so far. In the last half inning he pitched, he actually recorded the 4 strikeout inning that you usually don't see. So he had the 1 pass ball. The Diamond Hoppers are having a lot of trouble figuring out his off-speed pitch. He's attacking this zone, and it's really worked out for him here, as the number 9 hitter in the Diamond Hoppers order, Joe Fiorino, steps in, and he'll look to lay down a bunt that goes foul back to the screen.
Yeah, as much as Alex Kinch is enjoying this, just as much as Alex Bell, is his 2 errors haven't come back to cost them at all, as Kinch has just been dominant.
Swinging another tap foul at home plate, as Fiorino finds himself in a quick hole, 0-2 here to lead off the bottom of the fifth, as the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers are on top of the Diamond Hoppers, 5-0. Good eye there by Fiorino as he takes a ball low and inside. As we said, Kinch works fast into the windup, and he bounces another ball in there. That one kind of eats Alex Bell up, but nobody on base, so the on-deck hitter, Ricky Castro, gets it and tosses it out of play.
Fiorino came into this game hitting .416, impressive early on this season.
Another foul at home plate. Infield plays him back. Fiorino has showed some speed this year. Number 1 for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers, as Alex Kinch shakes off catcher Alex Bell as he's into the windup. The delivery, another curveball low and in the dirt, and just kind of missing with that curveball, and Fiorino showing some good patience, not chasing as we've seen some of the other Diamond Hoppers do so far in this game.
As effective as Kinch has been, you've seen him shake off Bell quite a few times this game.
Full count, strike 3, swinging as he goes down on a fastball low and outside. And that's 5 straight strikeouts here for Alex Kinch. And that'll give him double digits. Second pitcher in the USPBL this year to reach the double-digit strikeout mark.
The other being Evan Pachota for the Utica Unicorns. And we're just in the fifth inning.
We'll bring up Ricky Castro, who steps in there and takes a ball. 0-2 today, grounded out to the third baseman and grounded into a fielder's choice in his last at-bat. Takes ball 2 outside. The Diamond Hoppers are wearing their white pants with the green pinstripe and their green uniforms with the frog spots on them, as that is their alternate jersey. The other The Beavers are in their all-blue tops, gray pants, red caps with the blue brim, as it's a 3-0 count on Castro, and he'll take a strike over the middle of the plate from Kinch to make it 3-1.
76 pitches so far for Kinch, but you see a little bit of action down there in the bullpen.
Ground ball slapped foul by Castro, mishandled by the first base coach as he'll toss it over to the Beavers dugout.
This is just the third start for Alex Kinch, pitched one game out of relief, so maybe on a pitch count so far. We'll keep an eye on that.
3-2 pitch, driven up the middle, over the shortstop's head, out to center field as Pepe corrals it and tosses into the cutoff man, DJ Martinez, as Ricky Castro's aboard with a base hit here with one out in the bottom part of the fifth inning.
Good job by Ricky Castro getting his second hit of the day so far. Try to get some speed on the base pads and get a run across the board for the Diamond Hoppers. You wonder, with one out here, if they want to try some hit and run with a guy who makes a lot of contact, Cam Stewart.
Cam Stewart, second baseman, 0 for 2 today. As you said, Ricky Castro reached on that hit, and look for him to be off and running as he's got some speed for the Diamond Hoppers. Cam Stewart took the first pitch as a ball. There's one out here in the bottom part of the fifth inning. The Diamond Hoppers down 5 runs, looking to get on the board here as the ball's hit foul and back out of play down the first baseline. And that gets, that eludes the fans even as it heads over the kind of awning there that covers the top part of the concourse here on the second level.
Ricky Castro already has one stolen base so far today. Is
1-1 as Cam Stewart looks to lay down a bump but pulls it back and called strike.
As that first time he got a stolen base, it was thrown away there but able to be corralled there by the shortstop Martinez.
1-2 pitch from Kinch, grounded the third baseman Kennan, bobbles, gains it, picks it up, tosses over to first for the out to get the speedy Cam Stewart.
I don't think they would have got two on that play, but it was because it was Castro got down there in a hurry, but still a nice job of recovering there by Kennan at third base.
Yeah, good job staying with it, like you said. Probably not going to get two. Cam Stewart runs very well, and it wasn't a hard hit ground ball, so Kennan makes a smart play. I think looked like he was going to first base the whole time, and that'll bring up Corey Caswell, the designated hitter tonight, with two outs, a runner in scoring position for the Diamond Hoppers. And a ground ball picked up by DJ Martinez. Stretch
wow.
At first by Corey or Slater, and that is out number 3
wow,
to get
impressive.
Corey Caswell. Dan Kennan was diving in front of that ball, but DJ Martinez picks it up deep in the hole, tosses over to first for the third out. One hit in the inning, no runs, no damage done for the Diamond Hoppers as we head to the top half of the sixth inning here on the USPBL YouTube channel.
Hey fans, let's look at the video board and see who has a birthday today. Happy 13th birthday, Noah. Happy birthday, Tony Pagano. Happy 8th birthday, Kayla. Happy birthday, Gary Lewis. Happy 40th birthday, Bob Multigliotti. Happy 12th birthday, Big Dog Kenneth. Happy birthday, Sherry Wilk. And now let's see who our VIP guests are. Leading off of the Beavers, catcher number 35, Alex Bell.
Welcome back here for the top half of the sixth inning as the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers hit here against facing John Tangerlini again. Alex Bell, Dan Kennan, Corey Slater, your hitters due up for the Beavers. Alex Bell's been held hitless today, something that hasn't been done in his first 3 games in the USPBL, as he takes a first pitch strike from John Tangerlini.
Just an impressive play there by DJ Martinez on that last play of the half inning there, showing some great range and a great cannon there at shortstop.
Bell lays off the curveball inside, runs the count to 1-1. Weak fly ball. Jamie McMillan over into foul territory and catches it in the palm of his glove for out number one here in the fifth inning. Excuse me.
Held hitless so far on the day for Alex Bell, but definitely a lot more work for him to do when he's behind the plate, working with that pitcher, getting on the same page. So that's why I'm always impressed with catchers who are so effective with the bat as well.
Yeah, because they play such a big role in the other part of the game, and they have to be on the same page with the pitchers. Dan Kennan now steps in to bat, 0-for-2 in today's game. Tangerlini starts him off with a off-speed pitch up and in.
Dan Kennan made a nice play last inning to recover after a short bobble, made a strong throw over to first base.
The sun has left Jimmy John's Field as we are now under the lights. You still see it off in the distance on the trees up in the tree line. Is a beautiful night for baseball as we have fireworks later on for you. Just a clear summer night here in Utica, Michigan. 3-0 Dan Kennan is the count as Tangerlini has yet to find the strike zone in this plate appearance, but no breeze. Lots of fans here for the fireworks, and it's just an all-around great atmosphere here down at Jimmy John's Field. Taking on the 3-0 pitch, and Tangerlini splits the plate for strike one.
Yeah, we've been really spoiled here. Outside a couple days of rain, the weather's just been perfect.
Line drive caught by Alex Delgado. Kennan hit it sharply, but right at the third baseman Delgado for out number two in the top half of the sixth inning.
How many times do we have to mention it? Delgado, a guy at third base who always seems to be in the right position, made another good play there at the hot corner.
First baseman Corey Slater steps to the plate, 0-for-2 in today's game, couple strikeouts, as he was a new addition to the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. Swing and a miss at a ball down and away. Looked a little upset with himself for swinging at that one way out in front, lunging at the ball.
Yeah, Nick Wilson getting a break out there in the field, DHing tonight.
0-1 from Tangerlini's and curveball that drops in there for strike two. And Tangerlini quickly ahead of Corey Slater here in the top of the sixth inning. Two strikes, two outs, nobody on. Ball slapped out to right field. Nagy tracks back to his left a few and just corrals the ball for out number three, a weak hit fly ball out to right field. No hits, no runs, nobody on in the top half of the sixth inning. We'll move to the bottom half here as the Diamond Hoppers look to get on the board here at Jimmy John's Field as you listen to United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel.
And your pitcher, please. Now pitching for the Beavers, number 12, Drue Bravo.
Drue Bravo takes the mound for the Beavers here as Alex Kinch is done for the day. Five innings pitched, three hits, no runs, 10 strikeouts as he faced 21 batters. Only gave it up to three hits. Nothing really hit hard. Didn't have a runner advance past second base on him, so stayed out of trouble here in the game. So good start for Kinch as he is in line for the win. Yeah, Drue Bravo on the mound.
Good job for Kinch as Drue Bravo's on the mound. We're seeing him for the first time as well as all of you. So looks like a fastball in there for a ball. It's another great job of pitching by the Beavers. It's two consecutive great starts by them in a row.
1-0 pitch, broken back by Delgado, scooped up by DJ Martinez. Quick flip across the diamond to Corey Slater, and out number one as Nelson comes in and retires the first batter he faces.
You know, something worth noting, James, obviously a four-game win streak for these Beavers, and the last four games they've given up four total runs. That's phenomenal pitching. If you're pitching that good with a shutout last game, you're going to win ball games.
Jamie McMillan steps in the plate, and now you see Dan Kennan kind of creeping up even with the bag as he shades over towards the shortstop side of second base, because Jamie McMillan threatened to lay down a bunt in his last plate appearance. Ball slapped foul into the screen. Nelson's pitched in a few games for the Beavers this year. He's pitched 2 2/3 innings. No runs given up. Four strikeouts. Foul back to the screen by McMillan.
Nelson from Lexington, Kentucky. A 6'3", 200-pound righty. Been very effective with four strikeouts and 2 2/3 so far.
Works ahead of McMillan, ball outside as it's now 2-2. There's one out, got the broken bat. Ground ball to shortstop by Alex Delgado to lead off the inning. And Jamie McMillan steps in, looking to do some damage. Couple hits, six hits on the season. Ground ball tapped foul down towards the Beavers dugout. The little young bat boy for the Beavers runs out and picks up the ball and takes it back to the dugout.
Yeah, McMillan cooled off a bit after a hot start, trying to get going again here, 0-2.
Close pitch there. They're going to peel down to first base. Not much the first baseman can, or first base umpire can do there. 3-2 count. 3-2 count on McMillan. One out here, and strike three called. As Nelson paints the inside corner, McMillan was starting to trot down to first base. Now he'll take a slow walk as he shakes his head back to the third base dugout. As home plate umpire rings him up on the called third strike from Drue Bravo. First pitch to Alex Santana. In there for a strike, as we got two outs here in the bottom of the sixth inning. The Beavers are on top of the Diamond Hoppers 5-0 as they look to continue their four-game winning streak. Excuse me.
Good off-speed pitch there by Drue Bravo as he had Santana off balance on that swing.
Quickly ahead of Santana, 0-2 here as there's two outs. Ball low and outside, skips away from Alex Bell. He'll get a new ball from the umpire. Beavers started the season 0-3 as they didn't have much hitting other than Nick Wilson, but as soon as they started getting some more hitting behind and in front of Nick Wilson, they've put together a four-game winning streak here. They look to make it 5 tonight as they lead the Diamond Hoppers in the sixth inning 5-0.
Both teams, both teams coming here tonight after that win for the Diamond Hoppers at 4-3. So whoever wins tonight, atop at first place.
2-2 count here, two outs. Swing and a miss. Alex Santana goes down swinging. Andrew Nelson strikes out two in the bottom half of the sixth inning. We move to the top half of the seventh. 5-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers here as you're listening to the United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel.
And now, folks, it's that moment you've been waiting for. The Kiss Cam brought to you by Tappers. Attention, please. Now pitching for the Hoppers, number 18, Jalen Miller.
Welcome back here to Jimmy John's Field for the top of the seventh inning. Jalen Miller takes over on the mound for his new team, the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. He started the team with the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. He's now part of the Diamond Hoppers squad. And he had some action with the Beavers early in the year.
In two games so far, Jalen Miller was pitching 1 2/3 innings, two strikeouts, three base on balls on five hits, had one loss. This will be his first game with the Diamond Hoppers. Jalen Miller stands in there at 6'185", so a smaller stature pitcher.
First pitch to Miles Williams, low and inside. From Jalen Miller, facing his old teammates, or the teammates he started the year with. As we said, he's now pitching for the Diamond Hoppers. Miles Williams takes another ball inside and tight.
Well, I would say he would know these guys better than anybody, but some of these guys don't know each other that well as we're only a few weeks into the season.
Quickly behind here, 3-0 to Miles Williams. Let's see if in a 5-0 game, Chris Newell will give Miles the green light here on 3-0. Strike on the inside part of the plate. Looked like he was taking all the way, so no green light. 3-1's the count on Miles Williams. Double in the first. Double in the second, excuse me. Out into the right center gap.
Yeah, he made an aggressive tag late there too when the ball was hit out to Nagy to third base. That's definitely been a MO, though, for for Miles Williams is he's aggressive in everything that he does, and we've already seen that cannon out there.
2-2 pitch is driven back to Nagy on a line, but a couple steps to his right, and Nagy's there to make the first out of the inning. Something to note here, Alex Delgado grounded out on a broken bat single in the top half of the last inning, and he's since been replaced at third base by a new player signed by the East Side Diamond Hoppers, Ryan Willard. Plays some shortstop, also third base, infield kind of utility guy. He's played some college ball at NC State, North Carolina State, as Jalen Miller throws an off-speed pitch there that doesn't do a whole lot of breaking and stays up for ball one against DJ Martinez. So Willard's your new third baseman. Jalen Miller's the new pitcher. Everything else still the same.
That'd be a big loss there. Hopefully Delgado is going to be okay for next game, and it's just precautionary.
It could also just be wanting to get the new guy Willard some playing time here. It's the seventh inning, 5-0 game, so get the new guy some reps, and let's see if the Diamond Hoppers can work on a comeback here. 3-0 count, strike one after DJ Martinez stands in there. Jalen Miller fell behind 3-0 to Miles Williams before getting him to line out to right field Nagy, and now he's brought it to a full count after DJ Martinez swings and misses at the 3-1 pitch. There's one out here. 5-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers as we play here at Jimmy John Field. The 3-2 pitch tapped foul at home plate by DJ Martinez. Got a good piece of catcher Chris Powers there.
Good job to stay alive there by DJ Martinez, who comes into this at-bat 1-for-2 with a single. Played some very solid shortstop in this game, making a couple great plays. The one a couple half innings ago where he was on his knees but was still able to make a throw to second base to get the out.
DJ Martinez, like you said, has played a pretty spectacular game in the field at shortstop. The 3-2 takes low and outside on a close 3-2 pitch there from Jalen Miller, but he issues the base on balls to DJ Martinez to flip it over to the top of the lineup as Dave Pepe steps in now.
Yeah, Dave Pepe done a good job today to get on base. 2-for-3 with the two singles. Somebody who struggled early on this season, but looking to turn it around.
First pitch low to Pepe as he takes ball one from Jalen Miller. Walks were something that Miller had a little bit of problems with, as he only pitched in an inning and two-thirds while part of the Beavers staff, but issued 3 walks. And we've seen here so far in his first appearance for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers, a little sporadic around the strike zone as he just threw another ball up to Dave Pepe that wasn't even close to the strike zone.
That'll drive a manager crazy when somebody comes out of that bullpen. You just want him to throw strikes, but definitely
2-0 count on Pepe. Guys. Strike on the outside part of the plate. Infield, middle field, depth. McMillan holds Martinez at first. Willard a couple steps behind third base. Runner goes. Throw from Powers hits the runner as it tailed back towards the second base side of the bag. And DJ Martinez has a stolen base here. Gets himself into scoring position after the stolen base.
Good job by DJ Martinez to looking to manufacture another run here.
Got a really good jump there, and the throw from Power tailed back into the runner, and there was no chance for the shortstop to make a play on that ball. Swing and a miss by Pepe. Counts full. One out. Runner on second base is DJ Martinez. Jalen Miller, the pitcher for the Diamond Hoppers, checks it.
Ooh,
and
very close.
Appeal to the middle. The umpire in the midfield says Pepe held up So we have trouble brewing here for Jalen Miller as he's walked the last two hitters to bring up Aaron Bossy.
Yeah, those can be hard calls there, but I think that was the right call. Pepe held back a little bit on that swing to work a walk. So that's three times on this ball game Pepe got on base, something that we talked about. He needed to do more for the top of this lineup as you have two guys on looking to score more.
First pitch to Bossy is low and away. And again, Jalen Miller is just continuing to have problems locating the strike zone. Aaron Bossy still looking for his first hit here as he joined the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers in their last game from Marshall University.
Yeah, but brings a resume where it says hitting, hitting, hitting all over the place. So it's only a matter of time.
2-0 to count as he fouls the ball off his ankle at home plate.
I mean, it can be take a little bit to adjust. I think you mentioned last game from, you know, you go from aluminum bats to the wood bats. I mean, still a good hitter, but it's going to take a couple games for him.
Yep, and this is a professional league level, so there is an adjustment. After coming from collegiate ball, grounds the ball to the shortstop, Castro flips to second, and that's all they'll be able to get. Looked like third baseman Willard was going to cut it off, and
yeah.
Castro called him off at the last second. Flips over to second baseman Cam Stewart for the force out to leave Beavers on the corners here in the top part of the seventh inning.
Yeah, good play there by Castro to call him off, because I think Willard was definitely going to first base. I don't think he would have, with his momentum, carrying him over to first base. I don't think he would have had a play at second.
We runners on first and third for the left fielder, Eric Phillis, who already has two RBIs tonight. Takes a ball outside as Jalen Miller has fallen behind all four batters here in the seventh inning. He's able to get Miles Williams on a line drive out to right field, walked the next two hitters, and got Aaron Bossy to ground into a 6-4 fielder's choice. Bossy on first. Martinez on third are your runners. Phillis takes a big cut at that fastball offering from Miller. Swings right through it for a strike. 1-1, two outs as Miller looks into Powers for the sign. He sets, holds the glove at the belt, and delivers. Phillis takes the ball low and inside. 2-1's the count.
Yeah, you got the right guy up at the plate. Two RBIs already for Eric Phillis, who's just been on fire. But right after that, Nick Wilson, it doesn't get any easier for Jalen Miller.
Swing and a miss. Another big rip by Eric Phillis. Center fielder Alex Santana shades him a little bit to the left side of second base, so lots of room in that right center field gap between Nagy and Santana. Check swing went around. Miller gets the strikeout of Eric Phillis. They threaten, get runners to third base, but do not score here. The walks don't hurt Miller as we move to the bottom half of the seventh inning. The seventh inning stretch here at Jimmy John's Field. Take me out to the ball game, sang by our PA announcer. And we'll be back for the action here at Jimmy John's Field on the USPBL YouTube channel. Welcome back here to Jimmy John's Field as Take Me Out to the Ball Game, sang by our wonderful fans here in attendance. Bottom of the seventh inning, 5-0 Beavers over the Diamond Hoppers. Andrew Nelson back on the mound for the Beavers going into his second inning of work.
As we see Father's Day being advertised, the game, the Utica Unicorns versus the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers featuring Stan's strength team. That'll be another fun day for all the fathers to bring their sons and daughters to this game and enjoy some great Sunday afternoon baseball.
Yeah, we also have next week, we have Meet the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. Wednesday, June 22nd, as it's a rematch of this game being played right now. And tomorrow, the Unicorns will play, and it is Unicorn Drawstring Bag Day. First 1,000 fans get a Utica Unicorns Drawstring backpack as Nelson hits the outside corner as with a strike to right fielder Tom Nagy, who has a hit in today's ball game. Swing and a miss. Aggressive swing on an off-speed pitch. Nagy doesn't wear the batting gloves. Kind of a crouched stance in the right-handed batter's box. Slightly open. Bat over the back shoulder, kind of tilted forward as he gets ready to throw. And
oh boy.
The ball way outside from Nelson skips in and off the back wall and bounces all the way back out to him as he'll trade that for a new ball.
Yeah, that one missed, I believe, what was it, Bob Uecker that said just a bit outside.
Yeah, that was more than just a bit outside. 1-2 count on Tom Nagy here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Andrew Nelson rings up Tom Nagy, and we have one out here. Lots of strikeouts for pitchers of the Beavers today.
That's the third strikeout for Andrew Nelson so far after 10 for Alex Kinch, and just three hits on the day for Beavers pitching against them. So very, very effective so far.
Catcher Chris Power now up to bat. Takes the first pitch outside for a ball. Infield back, Nelson works out of the stretch. Bounces a ball in there to Bell. 2-0 is the count. Nelson wears the number 12. Gets the sign from Bell and holds the glove at his chin. Swinging a ground ball to shortstop DJ Martinez, tosses across the diamond to Slater. Easy play, 6-3 ground out from Chris Power.
Looks like Dan Cannon was called off there as he was aggressively pursuing that ball, but just an easier play for Martinez there. Cannon would have kind of thrown he would have been a little off balance on that throw, but a out nevertheless, two outs in the inning.
The nine-hitter, Joey Fiorino, takes a curveball inside. And on that last play, you're as a third baseman, you're taught to go for the ball till the shortstop calls you off. Sometimes cutting the ball off across the diamond, it makes it for an easier play because it's a shorter throw as your momentum carries you towards first base. But as we saw there, an easier play for DJ Martinez to step and throw, make a good throw over to Corey Slater at first base as Fiorino. 1-1 count. Ball outside.
You also had a catcher running there, and Chris Power, so that comes into play as well. You have a faster runner. Maybe that third baseman needs to make that play all the way.
2-1 count on Joe Fiorino. Takes a strike in there. Splits the plate. The Beavers are on top 5-0 here as we play ball in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Deuces wild as Fiorino lines a ball back into center field. Takes a couple steps and Dave Pepe corrals it and tosses it back in. So base hit there for Joe Fiorino to bring up the top part of the order, Ricky Castro.
Good approach there by Fiorino. That's just the third hit of the day by these Diamond Hoppers as they've been controlled so far early on, as the story has been the dominating pitching early on. It was Alex Kinch, and relievers have come in here, Jalen Miller, and shut the door, but a runner on for the Diamond Hoppers.
Ricky Castro stands in, takes a ball outside, two outs. Most of the hits for, three of the four hits for the Diamond Hoppers have come with two outs, so they haven't really been able to put any real pressure on any of the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers pitchers. Strike on the outside part of the plate. Even his count, 1-1, as there's two outs here. Joe Fiorino has some speed down at first base, can take a bag, but the Diamond Hoppers need runs, so he can't be afford to be thrown out on the base passes. Nelson misses away with a curveball, 2-1, the count on the lefty Castro.
Yeah, rarely do errors not come back, especially throwing errors, to affect the team as you have a ball there, but as both errors were on the catcher, Alex Bell, but just the pitching has just shut down these bats where it hasn't come back and hurt them, which is good for them.
3-1 pitch high, and we got two runners on as Ricky Castro draws the walk from Andrew Nelson.
Second baseman, number 2.
We'll bring up Cam Stewart, who has the ability to change this game with one swing of the bat here.
Yeah, a two-out hit single and a walk. And now you have Cameron Stewart, who has shown some pop this year with one home run. As you said, he, with one swing of the bat, can change this game.
First pitch to Stewart, rip and swing and tapped foul back to the home plate screen here. Gets the oohs and ahs from the fans as they always feel like the ball's coming at them, and sometimes you forget the screens there. But Diamond Hoppers looking for a clutch two-out hit here as we play ball in the seventh inning, bottom part of the seventh. The Diamond Hoppers, the home team. Cam Stewart takes a curve ball over the middle of the plate for a strike, and Andrew Nelson quickly ahead, 0-2, as we call time for a ball that was on the field. Bat boy runs down and takes care of that. Two outs, two strikes on Cam Stewart, two runners on. Andrew Nelson sets and delivers, and another tap foul softly down the first baseline.
James, as we enter week three here, the USPBL, what's been the most surprising or impressive thing to you so far?
I really think this Beavers team has been probably the most impressive. Strike three called on the outside corner.
Right on key there.
Andrew Nelson strikes out Cam Stewart with runners on first and second, paints the outside corner. We'll head to the top of the eighth. Beavers 5, Diamond Hoppers 0 here on the United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel. New pitcher takes over on the mound for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers, and that is number 11, Matt Rogers. Hometown kid from Clarkston, Michigan. 23 years old. He's appeared in three games for the Diamond Hoppers. Pitched an inning in 2/3. Hasn't allowed a run yet. Only three hits given up in that time. 5 strikeouts, no walks. So another pitcher that comes out of the Diamond Hoppers bullpen and throws strikes and gets batters out here as we take over. But to go back to your point on what has impressed you so far 3 weeks into the season, and I think it's just, for me, it's the turnaround of this Beavers team as we watched Nick Wilson really carry the team. The first, they got good pitching, but they couldn't score any runs for their pitchers. They lost a couple low-scoring games to the other two teams in this league. And now that they've added hitting behind into their order with their pitching, they become a more dominant team.
Yeah, I'd have to go with you as well with that one. But just to change it up and have some difference here, I'm going to say the starting pitching. As we already mentioned, Evan Pechota having the 11 strikeouts, becoming the first to get double digits in a game. And then tonight, 10 strikeouts, as we'll talk more about that after this pitch.
Nick Wilson, the batter here for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers in the top half of the eighth inning. Home run already today to right center field.
And Alex Kinch with 10 strikeouts today. It's just been really impressive.
Swinging a ball hit out to right center field again off the end of the bat. So Nagy camps underneath it. Sounded loud, as every ball that comes off Nick Wilson's bat does, but off the end of the bat, and just a easy fly ball out to right field for Matt Rogers to start the inning with, to get Nick Wilson there on the fly out to right field.
Alex Bell 0 for 3 on the day, but a very dangerous hitter.
First pitch from Rogers, fouled, back and out of play.
Very aggressive hitter, Alex Bell, as he swings first pitch there, and he's been pretty patient so far today, but as we said, playing catcher, a little bit more responsibility for him today.
Ball slapped out to right field, Nagy chasing back, and that's going to get over his head and ground rule double as it bounces over the fence. That ball just kept carrying off the bat of Bell. I thought Nagy took a couple steps back into his right, and it looked like he was going to camp underneath it, but ball kept going over his head, hits the warning track, bounces over, so can't keep Alex Bell hitless all game as he gets the ground rule double to right field there.
This is the fourth game for Alex Bell, already his fourth double on the season as he had two opening day, so we shouldn't be too surprised with that ball carrying, as Alex Bell has done that with about every at bat that he's had. He's driven that ball out there, so 1 for 4 on the day.
Dan Kennan steps in and takes a ball outside on an off-speed pitch, lined out to third baseman Alex Delgado in his last plate appearance.
Kennan 0 for 3 on the day with a runner in scoring position there at second base, trying to drive Bell home here.
Delgado since replaced by Ryan Willard, the new addition to this Eastside Diamond Hoppers team, signed earlier today. Kennan takes a strike there from Matt Rogers.
Kennan played his collegiate ball at New Mexico State University from Deming, New Mexico, for the 5'10", 175. Dan Kennan, listed as a shortstop, but as we've seen, plays all over the infield.
1-2. Low and outside from Matt Rogers. Infield plays Kennan straight up. Right fielder Nagy playing shallow out there in right field. Santana about straight up in center. And Fiorino, the left fielder, plays a little deeper. Outside, full count now, as Kennan lays off the high outside fastball. As I said, Matt Rogers, one of the few local kids that is taking part in the USPBL from Clarkston, Michigan. Just a few miles up the road here. Strike three as Kennan chases a ball outside of the strike zone, and he'll go down swinging for the second out of the eighth inning.
Good job there by the local kid there, Matt Rogers, just overpowering that pitch past Dan Kennan, who swung at that aggressively.
That'll bring up Corey Slater, 0 for 3 in today's game, still looking for his first hit in the United Shore Professional Baseball League as Matt Rogers delivers, and it's a ball outside.
Slater out of Butler Community College from Jupiter, Florida, 6'2", 245, listed as a first baseman, playing first base tonight as Nick Wilson DHs.
Another ball outside to Slater, and Matt Rogers behind in the count 2-0.
Slater, 0-3 on the night, looking for his first USPBL hit.
Strike crosses the outside corner on the fastball for Matt Rogers to make it a 2-1 count. Two outs here as the Beavers bat in the top half of the eighth inning. 5-0 is the score. Checks it, held up. 3-1 is the count.
Got a little activity on the Diamond Hoppers in the bullpen there.
First base open. Alex Bell, the runner at second base after he hit a ground rule double. Swing and a miss. Corey Slater swings at that outside and low pitch to make another full count here for Matt Rogers and the East Side Diamond Hoppers. Good. Slater stands in there, bat cocked over his head. Swing and a miss. Matt Rogers gets him on strikes. They get a runner to second base, but fail to get any further than that. The Diamond Hoppers bat in the bottom part of the eighth inning, down 5-0 to the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. You're listening to the United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel. New pitcher here on in the bottom part of the eighth inning, Eric Kimber from Greensboro, North Carolina. The 23-year-old right-handed pitcher, 5'11", 175 pounds. Why don't you give us some stats on him so far in the United States, or United Shore Professional Baseball League.
Yeah, Eric Kimber, four games so far this season, hasn't been scored upon. Five innings pitched, eight strikeouts, one base on ball. Two hits, so he's been dominant early on in this season as he's been able to, through his innings, he started two innings, had three strikeouts, his next appearance in just one inning, had a strikeout in at least every inning he's pitched so far. He's been very effective. Eric Kimber at just 5'11", 175, but hasn't mattered as he's overpowered these hitters early on in this season. And a great job so far by this Beavers team, James, as we mentioned. And as they had a shutout last game, looking to get another one tonight, you have to be impressed by the off-speed stuff of these starting pitchers so far.
Looks like Alex Bell's day is done as Ray Ortega takes over behind the dish for the Beavers. And we'd like to thank all of our listeners that are tuning in to the United Shores Professional Baseball League YouTube channel as the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers take on the East Side Diamond Hoppers. Kimber starts our designated hitter Corey Caswell off with a ball high. Diamond Hoppers looking for a bit of a rally here as they're down 5-0 in this game. Kimber misses outside.
Kind of a slow delivery. He starts slow and just speeds it up as he goes on with the delivery.
Ball ripped down the third base line. Going to get to the wall. That might be extra bases for Corey Caswell as he rounds first.
Uh-oh.
Almost takes a tumble, but walks, trots into second base, standing up, and leadoff man on here for the Diamond Hoppers as Caswell rips a double down the third base line.
Yeah, just a line shot for that double there, but fortunate there he didn't fall as he was flying around first base and just kind of lost his footing. So good job of hitting there by
They never said
Caswell.
Catchers were the sleetest of foot.
Yeah, definitely definitely showing he's a catcher here as he DH'd tonight, but not hiding it from us.
Continues to hit in the early part of the season. And that'll bring up our new third baseman that came in for a replacement of Alex Delgado. Ryan Willard from North Carolina State. First plate appearance in for the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. Seeing his first game action as he came in as a defensive replacement in the top part of the seventh inning. Now he gets to bat, gets a chance to bat for the first time as Dan Kinnon will go over and talk to Kimber.
Yeah, Ryan Willard, 6'1", 185 out of Smithsburg, Maryland, played his collegiate ball at NC State University. Listed as a shortstop, but came in today, as we mentioned, played a little third base.
Wearing number 12, bit of a crouch stance, takes a strike. 2-1's the count on Ryan Willard here as the Diamond Hoppers look to make a rally down 5-0 here in the bottom part of the eighth inning. That double by Caswell, the lead off and swing and a miss by Willard as he took a huge rip at that one, looking to make his first hit in the United Shore Professional Baseball League a home run, but swings and misses. Kimber evens the count at 2-2 now. Runner at second again is Caswell. Willard calls time, steps out, takes a practice swing, and back in there now, ready to go. Ortega gives Kimber the signs, and he's set, holds a glove at his chin, checks the runner once, into his delivery ball low to Ryan Willard.
So for his first at-bat, he's been very patient, working the count here. Good at-bat already from Ryan Willard.
2-2 is the count. Hits a ball high and down the first base side. Slater drifts underneath it, squeezes it just in one step in foul territory, still on the infield dirt.
Looked like he kind of snow coned that one there, but
and looked like he caught it in like the palm of his glove, almost popped out there. But Ryan Willard's retired for the first out of the inning, and manager Chris Newell heads out to the mound.
Got to wonder if this will be a talk just to buy some time, or if he's going to make the move. Looks like he's going to keep Kimber in there.
There's nobody throwing down in the Beavers' bullpen, so I don't know if he's checking on Kimber about something or telling him to work on something or what he wants him to do here, as the big first baseman, number 14, Jamie McMillan, will step in to face Kimber. Ortega lines up his defense the way he would like. Caswell is the runner at second. You see kind of this make, kind of a half shift here. You get the second baseman way out in center, in right field, about 10 steps. The first baseman, Slater, back about 15 steps behind the bag. Third baseman shaded over towards shortstop, and the shortstop, Martinez, deep, more towards the bag at second base as Kimber misses with the 2-0 or the 1-0 pitch to make it 2-0 now.
Yeah, we saw this last at bat for McMillan. I have to think this is his manager talking with Bossy doing this, but not quite a shift as you said, but definitely something different. We'll see more of this as time goes on.
Low and inside makes the count 3-0. Those that are Tigers fans out there, looks like Michael Fulmer is continuing his scoreless inning streak as he's gone through four innings without giving up a run in this game against the Royals. But 3-0 is the count here. McMillan takes a strike that splits the heart of the plate.
Yeah, speaking of Michael Falmer, he has just been very dominant and something that this team, that the Detroit Tigers needed to go along with Verlander.
Ball four inside. McMillan draws the walk, and now we got two guys on.
Good
for
job.
The center fielder, Alex Santana.
Good job by McMillan being patient up at the plate to work that walk as they have a runner in scoring position here, one out.
You almost wonder if that's kind of what manager Chris Newell talked about out there on the mound, was because they didn't really give – Kimber didn't really give anything for McMillan to hit. I don't know if that was part of the plan, maybe a non-intentional, intentional walk, but brings up the center fielder, Alex Santana. Swinging a ball, slapped down the right field line, but that'll get out into the crowd of fans down there in the right field pavilion.
It is,
and
just
they scramble for the ball.
Just packed here still as fans are enjoying this one, ready for some fireworks after the game, but I don't think anybody's leaving. This is just a great, perfect night for baseball. Great game.
Santana swings and hits another one back into the stands. Kimber quickly ahead on him, 0-2, as we bet here in the bottom of the eighth inning. 5-0, Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers on top of the East Side Diamond Hoppers. The 0-2 pitch from Kimber. Swing and a miss on a slider darting away from Santana. Ortega caught it behind the left-handed batter's box and got Santana to chase on the slider low and away for the second out of the inning. And that right there really makes me believe that they pitched around Jamie McMillan down at first base, because Kimber just threw three pitches there that he wanted to, where he wanted to, and he missed on five pitches to McMillan. Got the one strike in there. But Tom Nagy steps in, swings and misses at the first pitch from Kimber in this at-bat.
Yeah, just a great job executing his pitches versus Alex Santana, who did not have a chance to make contact in that last pitch. But great job by Kimber.
Two outs, runners on second and first. Swing and a foul tip into the glove by Nagy. 0-2. Kimber quickly ahead. Caswell hit the double to lead off the inning. McMillan drew the walk. Those are your runners on base. Tom Nagy, the hitter, quickly in a hole. 0-2 as Eric Kimber looks to move to the ninth. Ball outside. Tried to get Nagy to chase a fastball outside and away, but Nagy lays off.
A very deceptive delivery there by Kimber, who, as I mentioned before, starts his delivery slow and just winds up.
1-2, swing and a miss, pulls the string on a curveball, gets Nagy swinging as we move to the ninth inning. 5-0 Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers on top of the East Side Diamond Hoppers. You're listening to the United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel.
Last Friday night crowd really rocked this out. Let's show who's the better Friday night crowd.
Neil Diamond's Sweet Caroline takes us into the top of the ninth inning with the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers on top of the Eastside Diamond Hoppers. 5-0 here at Jimmy John's Field. Another beautiful Friday night at Utica, Michigan. Great crowd on hand to take in this one.
Even on country night, Neil Diamond can get all the fans to sing. It's a classic. You have to sing, and you find yourself. It's like the YMCA. You don't even know what you're doing as bugs fly in here into the booth, but it's just a tradition.
First pitch to Miles Williams was a ball. Was a strike on the first pitch. Takes a ball high on the next one. Miles had the double back in the second. Lays off the off-speed offering. As we had a pitching change here for the ninth inning, Darren Lauer takes over on the mound. Number 9, right-handed pitcher. Miles taps the ball foul down the third base side.
Yeah, Lauer on the season, 2 innings, 2 hits, no earned, and 3 strikeouts.
From New Hope, Pennsylvania, played his college ball at Keystone College. 6-foot righty. Has recorded a save here in the United Shore Professional Baseball League. I believe he actually recorded the first save.
Long discussion there on how they're going to attack Miles Williams. You have to think it might be something off speed here coming to Miles Williams, who looking for that fastball to drive.
2-2 count here to Miles Williams in the top of the ninth.
And he gets a fastball instead.
Fastball up in the zone. Lays off, ball 3. Miles has the white shiny cleats, white batting gloves. Ooh. Fastball way up and in. Has Miles
like that one.
Spinning out of the way. Some little chin music there from the pitcher Darren Lauer, and Miles will trot down to first base as the fans try to get the wave going here at Jimmy John's Field. And DJ Martinez, the shortstop, steps in. As we mentioned, had a very good game in the field. A single and a walk at the plate. 1-for-2 in today's game. So doing it all over the field is DJ Martinez tonight. Miles Williams draws the walk, and he's your runner at first. Another fastball up and in on DJ Martinez. Has him kind of turning the head down and in. Lauer's a little erratic here as he comes out of the bullpen. Hasn't pitched in a while.
As you mentioned, a single and a walk for Martinez. For your number 9 hitter on twice this game, that's a great game for him already.
Swing and a fly ball. Nagy comes in, stops, puts on the brakes, and puts that one in his back pocket for out number 1 here in the top half of the ninth inning. DJ Martinez retired on the lazy fly ball to right field.
Good job from Lauer after walking Miles Williams to rebound there and get the first out of the inning.
Leadoff hitter Dave Pepe steps in. 2-for-3 on the day, 2 singles, and reached on a walk. On base 3 times for the leadoff hitter today. And manager Chris Newell's lineup. Batted there all season. Played a couple different outfield positions. He's played some center, a lot of time in left field.
Pepe, 1 of the RBIs today. The other 4 coming from Eric Phillis and the 2-run homer from Nick Wilson.
Ball driven out to left field softly, and Joey Fiorino comes sprinting on, making the catch as he had to turn the jets on to catch that one as it was dying quickly off the bat of Dave Pepe, but Fiorino corralled it and makes the out. Could make it 2 outs here.
Good play there, running catch by Fiorino off the bat. I thought that was going to drop in, but got a good jump, a good read on that ball for out number 2.
Aaron Bossy's the hitter now, second baseman tonight. Number 19, second game in the United Shore Professional Baseball League, looking for that first hit. of his professional career.
For a guy that's had a lot of success with the stick in his career, that first hit might be the big one for him that get the rest of them coming.
Fouled back right to the screen.
It seems to be that first one kind of gets that pressure and the nerves out of the way. So as he's been aggressive so far this at bat, falling down 0-2.
0-2 is the count, as Dave said there. Miles Williams, the runner at first base, drew a walk earlier in this inning. Lauer pitches ball in the dirt. For those of you that did not hear the news earlier this week, Birmingham Bloomfield pitcher Ross Vance, left-handed pitcher, was signed to a minor league deal by the St. Louis Cardinals, making him the first pitcher in the United Shore Professional Baseball League to make the jump to affiliated ball from this independent league. So we want to congratulate him on that. And Bossy slaps it out to right field, but Nagy plays that right field position shallow and takes the line drive right to the bottom of the ninth. Last chance for the Diamond Hoppers, down 5-0 to the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. Here, you're listening to the United Shore Professional League YouTube channel. New pitcher here in the bottom part of the ninth inning for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers, Michael Doloff, newly signed, wearing the number 42 jersey for the Beavers, right-handed pitcher. Tomorrow, join us at the stadium as the Eastside Diamond Hoppers will take on the Utica Unicorns. And it is Utica Unicorns Drawstring Backpack Day. The first 1,000 fans will receive one of those. So if you're coming out to the ballpark, get out here early. Make sure you get your Unicorns Drawstring Backpack. And then join us again on Sunday, 2 o'clock game, as the Beavers, these Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers, will take on the Utica Unicorns. It'll be the Beavers' first home game of the year, believe it or not. They've technically been on a long road trip to start the season.
Well, After eight games, you got to think they're feeling pretty good on that away road trip.
Yeah, if the score stands, that'll make them 5-3. After they started off 0-3, win 5 straight games, as we said, if the score stands, as Chris Powers bats. First pitch was a strike, second pitch ball in the dirt.
And anything can happen. Rally caps are on in that Diamond Hopper dugout.
And that's how you get it started, with a hit. Chris Power goes the other way under the glove of, that looks like it's Alex Bell playing first base. So when we said Alex Bell was out of the game at catcher, we were wrong. It was Ortega who came in to replace, comes in Corey Slater's position in the lineup. Alex Bell remains in the lineup. He just went from catching to first base. So we've seen Alex Bell play a number of positions here in his short stint so far, 4 games, 4 different positions for him. But the leadoff guy on is Joey Fiorino steps in. Ball gets behind Ramon Ortega, and that'll advance Powers down to second base.
So getting that rally started the right way with a runner down at first for a single, and a pass ball already has somebody up here
at second base with Fiorino up. Try to put somebody across home plate with a single. You have to think a run's going to score.
Doloff misses high to Fiorino. Got to imagine manager Chris Newell saw this as a good spot to get a guy his first experience in the U.S. PBL. Newly signed misses low and away for ball number three to Fiorino, and he's in trouble of allowing the first two Diamond Hoppers to reach here in the bottom part of the ninth inning. And a four-pitch walk is issued to Joey Fiorino.
Rallying.
So we have some trouble brewing here for the Beavers as the first two runners reach.
And you mentioned Chris Newell, manager Chris Newell. That's a guy I think we can mention. That's, he's been hitting all the right buttons for this team early on. I like the way he's managed his pitching staff as well.
Yeah, he says he's got four starting pitchers that he believes in. I mean, you see Alex Kinch tonight. The other night you saw Nick Jensen Clagg. He also seen Forrest Kumis, who's been used more in a relief role so far, but manager Chris Newell sees him as a starting pitcher option, as that's what he was in college at the University of South Carolina. Kyle Carter steps in the pinch hit duty here. Pinch hits for Ricky Castro.
Kyle Carter also pitches out of that bullpen as well for the Diamond Hoppers.
Kind of a super utility guy, will play the outfield, anywhere in the outfield. And like you said, will also come out of the bullpen.
Looking for his first hit of his US PBL career.
Checks it. Ball two.
So now you're in a little bit of trouble here. 2-1 and two guys on. It could start to get interesting here in a hurry.
Ball slapped to third base. Kennan steps on the bag at third to get the force out, and that's all he'll get. Held the ball wisely, didn't throw it across the diamond as Kyle Carter was moving down the first baseline, but a hard hit ball right at the third baseman, Dan Kennan.
Yeah, sometimes the best play is the play you don't make, and he made a good play on that going to third base, but didn't offer at the throw there as they're up 5-0. If he throws that away, runners move up to second and third, so good job there by Kennan.
Cam Stewart's now your hitter. The second baseman. 0-for-4 in today's game. Takes a first pitch ball from Doloff. Broken bat, ball over to Kennan, fields it nicely. Tosses over to Bell at first base to record the out.
Second consecutive play made there by Kennan as the ball's found him. But if you're the Diamond Hoppers, that's the wrong guy to find because he's been very slick out there in the infield. A guy who can play anywhere around the horn, listed as a shortstop, but doing a very, very good job tonight defensively.
So Doloff put the first two guys on, then got consecutive ground balls to the third baseman, Dan Kennan. Stepped on third to get the Chris Powers and then made the toss over to Alex Bell at first base to retire Cam Stewart as Corey Caswell steps in. With two outs, runners on second and third.
Doloff's done a good job so far pitching in trouble here with runners on.
Ball hit up in the air, and Bell gives chase at first, but just watches it go out of play as Caswell takes a rip at a ball.
These fans, as you hear them with more oohs and ahs, they're having a good time here tonight, aren't they?
The fans always have a good time here. I think they really enjoy the baseball. It's great baseball. We've seen lots of hits tonight, lots of really good pitching,
some fireworks as well. I mean, does it get any better, you know?
It doesn't. A little half swing there by Caswell, who was out in front of the off-speed offering from Doloff, and the half swing fouls it back into the screen. And now the Diamond Hoppers are down to their final strike here. Down 5-0 to the Beavers. Runners on second and third. 1-2 count on the designated hitter, Corey Caswell, as the home plate umpire calls time.
Caswell 0-for-1 on the day.
popped off. Sets, delivers.
Ooh, where was that?
Close pitch to take there by Caswell. Ooh. Must have been up just a little bit as
it looked
Doloff froze him with the off-speed pitch, but just missed the zone. The 2-2. Ground ball, third base, scooped up by Kennan, tossed over to the first baseman, Bell, and that'll be it here as the Beavers win their fifth straight game. Alex Kinch will be your winning pitcher as they come out, shake hands, congratulate each other after the fifth straight win here for the East, or the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers. Diamond Hoppers' losing streak is one after their win last night against the Utica Unicorns. We'll be back to recap this game and get you caught up before the fireworks start here at Jimmy John's Field as you listen to the Utica or the United Shore Professional Baseball League YouTube channel. Welcome back here at Jimmy John's Field as the young kids run around the bases before the fireworks show begins. Beavers players stick around and high-five all the little kids as they run on the field. That's a cool sight to see. The little kids love interacting with the players here. But a fifth win in a row for the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers, as we've mentioned. They've given up four runs over that five-game win streak, including two shutouts in their last two games. So that's 18 scoreless innings from the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers pitching staff, and they were led by Alex Kinch tonight. Pitched five innings, gave up three hits, no runs, and struck out 10 Diamond Hoppers batters. And it was just an impressive performance from him, and we saw the same thing with Nick Jensen Clagg the other night, and they're really getting dominant starting pitch. I mean, dominant is the right word to say for these last two outings by Jensen Clagg and Alex Hinch.
Yeah, it's been really, really something to see, something special in this five-game win streak. Is starting 0-3 in the season, you got a lot of questions. Obviously, it's a long season. You're going to have your losing streaks. But ever since they put Alex Bell in that lineup, it's been a different team. And their pitching has stepped up this season. As you said, two shutouts in a row. And it's about that time where we give our player of the game. James, who are you going with?
I think I'm going to have to go with the pitcher, Alex Kinch. I know Nick Wilson had another big home run, added a couple more RBIs. Eric Phillis had a two-hit performance as well as adding two RBIs. But I just thought what Alex Kinch featured tonight out there on the mound was really good stuff, striking out 10 batters in only five innings. He faced 21 batters and struck out 10 of them. So a very dominant performance from Alex Kinch, as the Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers move to 5-7. They will be off tomorrow as the Eastside Diamond Hoppers will be back to face the Utica Unicorns. The Diamond Hoppers fell to 4-4 on the season. They'll look to bounce back against the Utica Unicorns tomorrow night after they beat the Unicorns the previous night before. We'll be here with the coverage on the United Shore Professional YouTube channel starting at about 7:25 game tomorrow night. So make sure you, if you can't make it out to the field for tomorrow's game, join us on the YouTube channel. For I'm James Zarnick. Alongside me was David Sisewski tonight. The kids are running the bases after a 5-0 Birmingham Bloomfield Beavers victory here at Jimmy John's Field as we get ready for fireworks. You're listening to the United Shore Professional Baseball Channel.
Single file, guys.